See, the topic is we are dealing with Cauchy sequences, and already explained the definition of Cauchy sequence. How to define a Cauchy sequence? A sequence Xn is said to be a Cauchy sequence if for epsilon greater than 0 there exists a natural number p such that mod Xn minus Xm is less than epsilon for all mn greater than or equal to p. This is the definition of Cauchy sequence. So always to start with a new topic, Cauchy sequence means you have to understand the definition first. What is Cauchy sequence? Cauchy sequence means for epsilon greater than 0, this is important. Corresponding to epsilon, we can find out p. That means this p depends on epsilon. So that mod xn minus xm less than epsilon for all mn greater than or equal to p. And I have already explained the sequence 1 upon n is a Cauchy sequence, and sequence n square is not a Cauchy sequence. We have proved this. Or the sequence n is not a Cauchy sequence. I consider some more examples later. First I prove that theorem. First part I have already proved. First result is, what is the first result? This is definition. First result on Cauchy sequence is, every Cauchy sequence is bounded. Every Cauchy sequence is bounded. Second result is, a sequence is convergent if and only it is a Cauchy sequence. So this theorem is important. This gives criteria for a sequence to be convergent. Understand, theorem is like this. A sequence is convergent if and only it is a Cauchy sequence. If and only, if you know the meaning of this. We take sequence convergent, then we prove that it is Cauchy sequence. Secondly, we take a sequence is Cauchy sequence, then we prove that it is convergent. Two parts are there. And this theorem is important from examination point of view also. And we use this as criteria for convergence. If we prove that a sequence is Cauchy sequence, then it is convergent. And if a sequence is not a Cauchy sequence, then it doesn't converge. So this is called Cauchy's general principle of convergence. Now I prove this theorem. I explain a proof of this. What is the theorem? Sequence is convergent if and only if it is a Cauchy sequence. First part, let Xn be a sequence which converges to L. Now what do we prove? We prove that it is a Cauchy sequence. Suppose Xn is a sequence which converges to L. Then by definition, for epsilon greater than 0, there exists p greater than 0, an integer p greater than 0, such that mod xn minus l is less than epsilon by 2, we take arbitrary number as epsilon by 2, for all n greater than or equal to p. So this is by definition. Suppose Xn is a sequence which is convergent or converges to L. By definition of convergence, there exists p greater than 0 for epsilon. There exists p greater than 0 such that mod Xn minus L is less than epsilon by 2 for all n greater than or equal to p. Take this as 1. Now, take m and n greater than or equal to p. Then, mod xn minus l is less than epsilon by 2 and mod xm minus l is less than epsilon by 2 for all mn greater than or equal to p. Now this is for all n greater than or equal to p. Therefore take mn greater than or equal to p. Then we have this one. Xn minus l is less than epsilon by 2. Xm minus l is also less than epsilon by 2. Take this as 2. Consider consider mod xm minus xn. Mod xm minus xn. It is equal to xm minus l plus l minus xn. We can write like this. It is therefore less than or equal to xm minus l plus l minus xn. Xm minus l plus xn minus l. Using simple absolute values means results on absolute values. What is this? Less than epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2 epsilon for all mn greater than or equal to p. Therefore, by definition of Cauchy sequence, what does Cauchy sequence say? A sequence is said to be Cauchy sequence if mod xm minus xn or xn minus xm less than epsilon for all mn greater than or equal to p. We would have taken xn minus xm also, that makes no difference. Or you can take xn minus xm here. Okay, xn minus xm, because in the definition we have taken xn minus xm. But this is not wrong, you can take xn minus xn less than epsilon also. So the first part is, suppose xn is a sequence which converges to L, then I explained the proof of xn is a Cauchy sequence. Now, converse. On the other hand, let xn be a Cauchy sequence. Xn be a Cauchy sequence. What do we have to prove? We have to prove that xn converges. Xn be a Cauchy sequence. Then, first thing is xn is bounded. Xn is bounded. Why xn is bounded? Because every Cauchy sequence is bounded. Therefore, xn is bounded. These things are important. Now, we use Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem. Weierstrass theorem. This I proved in subsequences. I have proved this. What does Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem states? Every bounded sequence, every bounded sequence has a convergent subsequence. Convergent subsequence. This is the theorem. See, we have started with this. Xn be a Cauchy sequence. Since every Cauchy sequence is bounded, Xn is bounded. By this theorem, this we have proved in subsequences. You refer to that one. It is important, that theorem. Every sequence or every bounded sequence has a convergent subsequence. Therefore, this xn has a convergent subsequence. Xn has convergent subsequence. Say, xnk. Xnk be the convergent subsequence of xn. And converging to L. This is by Bolzano's theorem. Converging to L. Let epsilon greater than 0 be any number, any arbitrary small number. What do we prove now? We have to prove that xn converges to L. Xn converges to L. Since xn is a Cauchy sequence, now we use this. Xn is a Cauchy sequence for epsilon greater than 0. There exists p, an integer, such that mod xn minus xm is less than epsilon by 2 for all mn greater than or equal to p. What do we have to prove now? We have taken xn converse of that theorem. Xn be a Cauchy sequence. We have to prove that xn converges. Since xn is a Cauchy sequence, xn has a, it is bounded by this theorem. xn has a convergent subsequence. What is that? xnk. And we have taken convergent subsequence at which converges to L. Now we have used here definition of Cauchy sequence. Since xn is a Cauchy sequence, we have this. Also, xnk converges to L. Converges to L. This implies there exists positive integer nk naught such that mod xnk minus L is less than epsilon by 2 for all nk greater than or equal to nk naught. Nk greater than or equal to nk naught. See, here we have used xn is Cauchy sequence. Here we have used xnk converges to L. Now we take T is maximum of this P and nk naught. Like T is equal to maximum of P and nk naught. Then what happens? Then mod xn minus xm is less than epsilon by 2 for all mn greater than or equal to t from this, and mod xnk minus L is less than epsilon by 2 for all nk greater than or equal to t. Nk greater than or equal to t. We use this as whether I had given a number for this. No, I give the number as 1 and 2. Say this is 1 and 2. In the converse part, I have used any number, any equation. So I take this as 1 and 2. Now consider, or first we prove, substitute here. Substitute m is equal to nk in 1. Then mod xn minus xnk is less than epsilon by 2 for all this, for all nk greater than or equal to t, n and nk greater than or equal to t. Say we have substituted m is equal to nk, because we can take here, because all nm greater than or equal to t, all nk greater than or equal to t. From this, we can substitute m is equal to nk. Consider mod xn minus L. Mod xn minus L is xn minus xnk plus xnk minus L. Am I right here? Xn minus L can be written as xn minus xnk plus xnk minus L. It is less than or equal to xn minus xnk plus xnk minus L. But from this, I take this as 3. From 2 and 3, it is less than epsilon by 2 for all nk greater than or equal to t. So what happens here? Mod xn minus L is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equal to t. Therefore xn converges to L. Xn converges to L. So if xn is a Cauchy sequence, then it converges. This completes the proof. What does theorem states? A sequence xn is convergent if and only if it is a Cauchy sequence. Two parts are there. First we take xn is convergent, then we prove that it is a Cauchy sequence. Second part, suppose xn is a Cauchy sequence, then it converges. And we have used there Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem. What does theorem states? every bounded sequence has convergent subsequence. In subsequences, I explained already proof of that one. This theorem is important from examination point of view. Definition, usually definition may be asked for 2 marks. Define Cauchy sequence. Define Cauchy sequence, or what is Cauchy sequence? When do you say that sequence is Cauchy sequence? For 2 marks. Secondly, prove that every Cauchy sequence is bounded. Next result is, a sequence is convergent if and only if it is a Cauchy sequence. That third result, this result is very important. Now, some problems are also asked in the examination. What are the problems? First, I have already proved 1 upon n is a Cauchy sequence. Prove that the following sequences are Cauchy sequences. First one, 1 upon n. Second, 1 upon n square. Third one, n by n plus 1. You know that sequence is denoted by its nth term. Sequence xn is 1 upon n square, n by n plus 1. They are Cauchy sequences. Fourth one, n plus 1 by n, it is a Cauchy sequence. And minus 1 raised to n upon n is a Cauchy sequence. 5 problems are there. Prove that the sequences are Cauchy sequence. Directly problem may be asked like this. Prove that the sequence, following sequence is a Cauchy sequence. What do you have to prove here? We assume epsilon is any arbitrary small positive number. For that epsilon, we can find out a positive integer p, so that mod xn minus xm is less than epsilon for all nm greater than or equal to p. That we prove. First one I have already proved. I take second one. Let xn is 1 upon n square. Therefore, xm is 1 upon m square. Now, without loss of generality, let us assume that n is greater than m. What is meaning of this, without loss of generality, n is greater than m? That means, first we assume that n is greater than m and prove that it is a Cauchy sequence. And suppose m is greater than n, the same proof is applicable. In place of m, you can use n. By reversing m and n, proof is applicable. That is the meaning of this. Now, let epsilon greater than 0 be given. Therefore, mod xn minus xm is less than epsilon implies, what do you have to prove now? For epsilon greater than 0, we can choose a positive integer so that mod xn minus xm is less than epsilon for all nm greater than or equal to p. That p we have to find out, or we have to prove whether that p exists. If it exists, then this is a Cauchy sequence. So, we start with this. Xn minus xm less than epsilon. What does this imply? 1 upon n square minus 1 upon m square is less than epsilon. This if and only for if xn minus xm is less than epsilon, if this is so, minus epsilon less than 1 upon n square minus 1 upon m square less than epsilon. Correct? That is if 1 upon m square minus epsilon is less than 1 upon n square less than 1 upon m square plus epsilon. Say, understand, we have started with this. Suppose epsilon be given, and so xn minus xm is less than epsilon if we come to this step. If 1 upon n square less than 1 upon m square plus epsilon and greater than 1 upon m square minus epsilon. Now, this is if 1 upon m square minus epsilon is less than 1 upon n square. That is, if 1 upon m square is less than 1 upon n square plus epsilon. This is true if 1 upon m square is less than epsilon. This step is important. See, we have started with xn minus xm is less than epsilon if 1 upon m square is less than epsilon. We came to this step. 1 upon m square is less than epsilon. Because 1 upon m square is less than epsilon, then it is less than epsilon plus 1 upon m square. It is positive. Now, this is if m square is greater than 1 upon epsilon or m is greater than 1 upon root epsilon. Now, if we choose p is a natural number immediately greater than 1 upon root epsilon. See, epsilon is arbitrarily, it is very small. Take epsilon is 0.00001, 1 upon 0.0001. 1 upon root of 0.0001 will be very large positive integer. We take, suppose it is not a positive integer, we take m is, p is a natural number immediately greater than 1 upon root epsilon. Then what happens? Then, now say this, p is greater than 1 upon root epsilon. Now, it is possible to choose a natural number which is sufficiently greater than 1 upon root epsilon. Then, for epsilon greater than 0, there exists p belongs to a natural number, so that mod xn minus xm is less than epsilon for all mn greater than or equal to p. Already we have taken n is greater than m, but this p is greater than mn. P is greater than m. Therefore, for all mn greater than or equal to p, xn minus xm is less than epsilon. Now, by definition of Cauchy sequence, this 1 upon n square, xn is 1 upon n square, is a Cauchy sequence. Remaining problem I explain in the next video. Thank you.